Look, let me just tell you something. If you remember nothing else from this entire dissipation, with all due respect to the men who earned the money, ladies, it's your responsibility, yours, to retain these truths and to impart them to your youths. Because they'll never know unless you tell them. Instinctively, in their childish wisdom, when they seek knowledge, they come to you. They know that you have bouffant haircuts. They know that you have room to store all this information and spray it with shellac so it'll stay there. A mother on my street walked in her son's room 4 o'clock in the afternoon. He was asleep. A grown-up son, 42 years old. And she went right to the bed with pointy shoes and she kicked him in the diagram. And she said, look at you. Look at you, 42 years old. Sleep. No work. Being a bummer, you're not bringing no money home. This house, cry my eyes at you. Shame, S-H-A-M-E, U-B-M, bump, M-G, no good, you. And the fella stood up with tears in his eyes. And he said, mother, why do you talk like that? We're not Italian. Look, I must tell you this. If you forget everything else, remember only from this lecture that we live in a great nation, that ours is a land of opportunity. Because brethren, sisters, where else but in the United States do people derive such great insulation from brilliant leaders in our history? People like Tom McCann, who stood up in Congress and said, if the shoe fits, wear it. Brigham Young, who assembled the morons in Salt Lake City and climbed up on a rock and said, I don't care how you bring them, just Brigham Young. He got in trouble. Paul Revere, who came home at 6 o'clock in the morning to pick up his horse, and his wife Agnes said to him, where are you going, Paul? And he drew himself up proudly and said, I'm a minute man. And she said, you're telling me? Look at the foresight and the integrity shown by our own President Johnson, who passed the Medicare bill just in time to cover his own hospitalization. Look at the courage shown by Christine Jorgensen, who stood up at the Medical Society in Denmark and hollered, cut it out. Look at Lady Godiva, who rode down the street in Coventry, England, no clothes, just long blonde hair all around her. And the poor people stood on the sidewalk going,